Hey guys, Heather of US Japan Fam here for a YouTube collab with some amazing moms of YouTube. So I'm gonna have in the video description a link to a playlist, and we are all gonna be uploading videos on the same theme related to baby making. The first topic on this grand theme of baby making is going to be conception. The moms are gonna be filming their stories and uploading them to the playlist, and mine on this topic is going to be how we conceived our baby twin girls. So keep watching for my story. Basically, if you rewind to New Year's Day 2015, my husband and I decided that it was time to have our second child, or try. So our first child took a few months, maybe like 4 months of doing the ovulation sticks and all that before we conceived him. And he had just turned 2 years old, and we decided to go ahead since we thought maybe 3 or 4 years was a good gap. And maybe if we went ahead and started, it might take like half a year or something. So we went ahead and started, and boom, first try, pregnant. How did we do this? Basically, I didn't fool around. I went right to what was our biggest helper, I think, was the ovulation sticks. You pee in a cup and you put the stick in there and it tells you if you are ovulating or not. Between my first baby and trying to have the second baby, I learned some stuff, and I don't know how accurate it is, but I don't know if you've heard about the Shuttles method. So basically, this is saying that the timing of conception, along with some other things such as diet and maybe position, also have a influence. But the most important influence over whether you have a boy or a girl is the timing. And the theory here is that boy sperm are faster, but girl sperm have a longer lifespan. So basically, if you do the deed on the day before or the day of ovulation, you are much, much, much more likely to have a boy. And when I learned this and I looked back at our first child, it is accurate, because when the ovulation stick said, boom, you're ovulating, we did it and we got pregnant, and that was a boy. Coincidence, I don't know, but it was accurate, and I was like, you know, I'd love to have a girl, so let's try. And so the theory for having a girl is that you should do the deed maybe 4 to 5 days before ovulation, and then don't do it again, because the theory is that any surviving girl sperm will have a chance, but if you do it closer to ovulating, those boy sperms will like beat them to the egg. So that's what we did. I kind of knew my cycle, and we did the deed like I think it was 3 or 4 days before the ovulation stick turned. I didn't think we were gonna succeed that first time. I thought, you know, 3 to 4 days ahead, that's like crazy. You don't know if your womb will support survival of any sperm at that point. But we were like, you know what, we have time. We don't wanna have our babies so close together anyway, so we'll just take our time with this. I will fast forward to it worked, and not just one girl, but two girls. So the Shuttles method worked for us for 3 babies. So check it out, I'll link that below. I think I did a blog post for Mommy Nearest on how that works. How we made the twins specifically, who the heck knows? There are so many factors that can increase your chance of having twins. So the one that most people know is genetics. So basically, there is a hypoovulation gene that some women carry, and when you hear that twins skip a generation, it's because they would skip the boy generation. So if a woman who has that gene has twins, and let's say they are boys, obviously they can't hypoovulate, but they would carry the gene to their daughters, who would have a higher chance of having twins. So that's how it would skip a generation. But basically, any girl in that line of the genes would have a very, very high chance of multiples, because that gene makes you drop multiple eggs each time. So I don't have a history of twins. After having twins, I kind of researched, and I did a blog post, I'll link that below, of crazy facts about twins, but there are actually tons of other factors that can increase your chance of having twins. And I don't know, if you're like out there like, I want to have twins, then you can try to do these things. You know, if you have twins, maybe this is why. But basically, being tall, check. being a dairy drinker, I don't know if this is from all the hormones and the dairy and the milk and cheese, I don't know, but check for me. Having extended breastfeeding, check, because I had breastfed my son for 2 years. And having recently weaned, check, I had only weaned my son 1 month. 1 month prior to conceiving our twins, I had weaned my son and I had breastfed him for 2 years. So that was probably a huge check right there. There are some other factors. Of course, any kind of fertility treatment is gonna really raise your chances, and we didn't do any assistance. As I said, the ovulation stick is the only kind of scientific-y thing that we did for conceiving. But you know, if you do any kind of fertility drugs or IVF, all of those things, even if you only put in one egg, it's still gonna, all of the drugs related to it increase your chance of that egg splitting. And of course, if you put in more than one egg, you're gonna have a chance that both of those eggs will implant and end in a twin pregnancy. Or, you know, you have the case where maybe you put in two eggs because you're like, well, maybe one will survive, but both of those make it and split, and then you end up with quads. So there are so many stories like this, like so many. So that really increases your chances right there. Twins, it's only like 3% of the population, but when you look at the factors, it's kind of interesting to see like which ones you had and why you ended up with twins. But what I'm really curious is, are my twins a fluke? As I mentioned, I'm tall, I breastfed for a long time, I recently weaned, I'm a dairy drinker. Those all kind of increase my chances of having fluke twins. What I'm curious to see is if maybe I had some kind of genetic mutation and suddenly I carry the hypoovulation gene, and then my girls will end up having twins and their girls will have twins, and I've started this whole big thing. So time will tell there. No idea. But anyway, that is our conception story. We were really lucky, and I feel so blessed. It's so cheesy to say that, but we were really lucky that we got pregnant so easily. I have so many friends and so many followers who struggle to get pregnant, and it's just like, I feel for them. Many, many women, a huge amount of women, really struggle to conceive, and it's not their fault. They were dealt those cards, and it sucks, and it's hard, and sometimes they get help and are successful, and sometimes they get help so many times and just have to give up because it's just, mentally, how do you go through that? Even just with my first son, it took us a few months, and each time you got your period, it's just like, oh my god. Oh, and you just felt kind of like a failure, and it's dumb to feel that way, because you're not a failure. And this is kind of why I wanted to do the collab, to see some other stories, to put them all out there together. We all have different conception stories and different ways that we made our babies or carried our babies or delivered our babies or raised our babies. So this collab and this series of videos in this playlist will hopefully bring together a great kind of all-around story of how babies are made and how there's a million ways to do it, whether you have a surrogate or you adopt. I hope that you find this playlist and this video relatable or helpful or just interesting, I don't know. But anyway, be sure to subscribe and bookmark this playlist, because each week we're gonna be uploading every Wednesday with a different topic. So this week was conception, and next week is going to be how you found out and how you announced your pregnancy. And the next week is gonna be the pregnancy, and then it's gonna be the childbirth. And the last one is gonna be postpartum, focusing on mental health of postpartum, whether you had baby blues or postpartum depression or everything was great. It's gonna also go over whether you breastfed or bottle fed, anything like that that you dealt with postpartum. So I'm excited for this collab. I hope you guys are too. Click below, watch all the videos, subscribe to the other moms, and support us all. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Bye.